when I started doing this stuff, you know, I was getting advice from a lot of people. A lot of people were saying, you know, do this, try this, work with this person, call this person, visit this person, you know. But in the back of my head, I kept thinking to myself, yo, man, all I need to do is just play this stuff for it. One day when Musa Keys was going there and I had a session with Musa Keys that day, and I said, oh, if you're going to Porter's house, I'm coming with you. It was the day before my birthday. It was like the eve of my birthday. Kanda Shisa was actually my official birthday present from Maphorisa, actually, because after spending the whole night talking, my nigga there just drops the beat, you know? And I heard this thing and I was like, damn, man, like that lock drum was knocking, you know? And I'm in the kitchen, he's in the lounge. I'm hearing this thing. So I leave the kitchen, now I'm coming around and I'm like, what is this thing that you're banging here right now, you know? This is like four songs down now. We probably made like a bunch of joints, but like this one comes on. And then I'm like, yo, man, can I have this one? Like, of all the stuff that we've done tonight, can I please have this one? I'm gonna put it here. Yeah, I'm fine, I'm in. You don't try. In the beginning, he was the one that came up with the idea of chopping and screwing the Kanda Shisa to begin with. Because when I was just saying, Kanda Shisa, he's like, yeah, if you look at it, at least the father, you pitch it down, little Kondo shoes. And then, like, then it evolves as, like, a chant. So that's how that song came about. It was my birthday, and I was about to go home. And we just locked up one quickly before I bounced. Papa Mokanda Shisa, Papa Mokanda Shisa, Papa Mokanda Shisa.
Poi lets you be like whatever you're into. He works around it. He gets to understand you and your sound, and then he works around that. So it's a very, very inspiring environment, because there's no resting. Like, you rest at 5 a.m. because there's, like, not even because you're forced to, but, like, there's just so much creative energy going on, one song after the other, like, concepts everywhere. Like, you get concepts from conversations in the house, because we're always just chilling, you know, just talking about each other, talking about what's happening in the industry, we're chilling, having a drink or hubbly. Like, it's always a vibe, but like a work environment, very much so. So it's really, really dope. I enjoy working with everyone that I get to work with. I was already well aware of the fact that I am working with people who are able to change my life, and I felt like whatever song I record with them is going to be out there. So I was like, let me use this opportunity and just instill my name in people's heads. So that's exactly what I was doing with Nia Lo. I actually had done another song before, which wasn't released because we actually liked Nia Lo better, but it was the same concept as me talking about myself, talking about my name and entering the industry. So that was my intention, very much so. And then, like, it worked out, and I'm very, very grateful for that.
Yeah. Water. What's up? Boss. That's it. That's some.